It's a very quick video just to show you how you can take two images and use a program called GIMP to merge those two images together. Okay, and this is about using layers. So it's very simple. So basically what I've done is I've got an image here, which is the American Gothic wood painting one, which is a bit of a classic painting. There we go, you can see that one. And I've got a picture of me. And then what we're going to do is we're going to merge them together so that we get something like this. But we could do it in different ways. We could make a picture of me stood in the window if somebody had taken an image that included more than just my head, or we could have me lying on the roof, or we could do lots of interesting and exciting stuff here as long as we've got an image to start with. So we're going to start with these two images, and it's this one we're going to start with first. We're going to use this program, which is GIMP, and it's free to download at gimp.org. Okay, and it will work on Windows, Linux, or on Apple computers. So most of the machines you guys should be using. Once I open GIMP, it's sometimes a little bit slow to load up because it loads all its packages and so on. So you have to bear with it a little bit while it goes through the startup window. And you can see mine's telling me that there's a new version of GIMP available, which I'm not going to download straight away because it's still a fairly recent version I'm using. So we'll just let that load for a second. Close that message, wait for GIMP to load all its scripts up, and GIMP will open. Now, GIMP sometimes opens in a single window mode like this, or sometimes it will open like this in three separate sections. Now, lots of GIMP users who've used it for a long time like that. If you don't, you just click on Windows, click on single window mode, and that pushes it back into single window mode. Then we're going to open the file. So I'm going to go and open this, and I've put this one into my downloads folder. So I'm just going to go into my downloads folder, and I'm going to start by opening the image of me. And in this one, all I want is the head. So choosing rotated, circular rotate. Okay. So on the left-hand side, what we're going to do here is we're going to use the free select tool. And I'm just going to go around my head. And the trick here really is to do as many little clicks as possible, because otherwise it looks like I've got a square head. I think I have got a square head. You can keep that to yourself. Okay, so here we go, around the edge, and because I want to put it on where his head is, I don't want my neck or anything. If you wanted the whole body and you'd got a friend to take a picture of it, you'd need to go further around the body. So I'm just going around here, clicking as I go. If I make a mistake, it's fine, I can just start again. And when I get to the end of it, I'm just going to press on Control, and I'm going to click on that one. You should see it's now starting to kind of flash, showing it's complete. Okay. We now go to Edit, and we go to Cut. Okay, and my face disappears. But what we can do now is we go File, Open, and if we open the normal American Gothic picture or any other picture, okay, we can now edit. And we can paste this as a new layer. So we've now got a picture of me on top of that, but it's not a very good picture, it's a bit big. So we're gonna use this one, which is called the scale tool, and we're gonna shrink my head down so it's not quite such a giant head, and use the move tool to move it on. So it's still a bit big there, kind of cartoonishly big. So we're gonna shrink it down again. And again, we're gonna use the move tool, and we're gonna move it so it's on top of there like that. Now, once we've done this, we're basically finished. All we now need to do, I mean, we can use things like the paint tool if we want to modify little bits on it, or we can use the eraser tool, or we can recolor bits, but the essential bit of putting the extra layer on is there. And you can see the layers show here. So if I switch this layer off, it goes back to his face. If I switch this layer back on, it comes back to my face. So the last thing, we're gonna go File, and then Export As. This is exporting as American Gothic, so I'm just going to call this new at the end, so we know it's a different file. I'm going to press export. And what you should see, press export again, is in our folder here, we've got this new American Gothic one. And when we open this up, you should now see it's got a picture of the original American Gothic picture on, but it's now me holding the pitchfork, which is probably a little bit scary. Okay.